All right, did you guys see what was going on there? I lost gas, so we got porosity the last inch and a half. So I'm not gonna show you how we got it or whatever. Our main goal is to fix this porosity right now, all right? So stick around, man cub. I'm gonna show you how to fix this porosity and remove it where you can't tell just by looking at the weld. It's never been fixed or never had porosity. All right, let's check this out. For all the new beginner welders, so if you guys don't know what you're looking at, this is a weld right here, all nice and continuous. And you go see here, looks like this blue, this like Swiss cheese looking crap right here. So that's porosity. So we want, that's bad. We want to get rid of that, all right? I don't care how we got it. I want to get rid of that, eliminate that porosity and make it look like it was never there. All right, so there's a couple ways you could do this. First, you could attack it by removing this whole weld. All right, you could do that way because this is a short weld. Or you just remove the last inch and a half, or just remove the porosity right here. Basically, mark right here, and I'm gonna mark right here, and I'm gonna remove that. So since this is a little weld, I'm gonna use this little Ferg thin wheel right here. You wanna use that thin wheel, because if I use a thick wheel, I'm gonna gouge into the base metal a little bit. I'm gonna have less, you know what I mean? I'll have a little bit more room to finesse it a little bit better. Because a big wheel, I'll have more of a chance to get a BMR, base metal reduction. So you don't want that to do that at all. So we're gonna go ahead and just take this wheel, put it on the grinder, and we're just gonna kind of feather that out and get rid of all that porosity and just keep working it back and forth and kind of shape that at a 90 again. That's our goal, and make it look back at a 90 and make sure all the metal's out. We want the metal 100% out and all the porosity 100% out. I'm using a Ferg 1/8-inch steel wheel. It's for steel, I mean. So what you wanna do is be cautious of the base metal when you're outside of your weld joint, not grinding into your base metal where you can see it visually. When you're doing a critical weld and you get base metal reduction, BMR, they flag you and a whole bunch of repairs and a lot of people griping and all the other stuff will happen. But you wanna keep just grinding your weld away, or grinding your porosity all the way where you don't see one speck. So I just started right off the crater where we grinded, or the metal where we grinded at, the good part of the weld. We started about a quarter inch ahead where I was gonna start. And I just, as soon as I pulled the trigger, I came back, retraced where I grind at of the good part of the weld, and just took off. And just watched my puddle, make sure I was fusing into the top good and the bottom good of the metal, base metal, and watching it melt in good. And just carried my way on all the way down until I stopped. And then, and that's about it. Like, as you see right here, there's a little high spot right there. If it was a critical weld, like nuclear work, they want you to feather that down a little bit so it's nice and even all the way down, all right? It's pretty easy, you can't tell. If I could do it, you guys could do it, all right? All right, guys, you're gonna use the same concept on basically every joint application or any welding application there. So just take this and learn from it and build from it. I hope you guys really learned something. Remember, we're here for you guys. Always shoot us emails, shoot us comments below. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit the bell. I mean, we're all here for you. Let us know what you guys want. We'll do it, try our best, all right? See you guys next time.